The Russian Navy could be the first nation to deploy hypersonic cruise missiles on submarines. Reports indicate that in 2020, a submarine-launched variant of Zircon missile will be test-fired from K-651 Kazan submarine. Currently, the US has Tomahawk missiles, which have a maximum speed of Mach 0.8. So it's not even supersonic. And in this regard, Russia is well ahead, as it already possesses submarine-launched supersonic missiles. In coming days, a successful test of Zircon from a sophisticated platform like Kazan will give it a massive edge. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the deployment of Zircon missile in Kazan nuclear submarine. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed speeds of Mach 5, or 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. There are currently two methods being applied to make hypersonic weapons. First is using hypersonic glide vehicle. In this method, the system is launched to extremely high altitudes using ballistic missile or an aircraft where it skips across the Earth's upper atmosphere. The vehicle then separates from the carrier, and the scramjet engine takes over, accelerating it to hypersonic speeds as it glides back to the Earth towards its intended target. Second is by using a scramjet engine. The scramjet is an innovation on the ramjet. Ramjet engine can power flight to supersonic speeds, but scramjet can enable the missile to reach hypersonic speeds. These engines have no moving parts, like the compressors and turbines used in the turbofan engines found on conventional jet planes. They rely on the huge pressures created by fast airflow into the engine to ignite the fuel and generate thrust. Zircon uses this method. It must be noted that traditional ballistic missiles like American Minuteman III, Russian Sarmat, or Indian Agni missile all travel at hypersonic speeds, but they follow a predictable ballistic trajectory and can't maneuver mid-course. As per President Putin's address in the Russian Federal Assembly, the Zircon is capable of reaching speeds of Mach 9. So it's much faster than a bullet fired from a sniper rifle. It's actually almost 3 times the speed of a sniper's bullet. The kinetic energy alone will rip a ship apart like a tin can. Mr. Putin stated that the missile has a range of over 1,000 kilometers or 620 miles. The missile weighs 5 tons. President Putin mentioned that the missile is able to destroy both seagoing and land targets. As per reports, the Zircon will have both radar target seeker and an optical electronic complex to detect and track targets. The missile could be equipped with a high explosive warhead or even a tactical nuclear warhead. Mr. Putin had told that the Zircon is mainly intended to be deployed in seagoing platforms such as serially made surface warships and submarines, including those that are already operational and being built. Kazan is the second boat of the Yasin class, separated from the first by 16 years, 1993 to 2009. Considerable changes were made to this from the first vessel, the Severodvinsk. The Russian Navy declared that the submarine would be improved in comparison to Severodvinsk. Differences in the design from the original project have been thought to be sufficient to consider it as a new version and named it Yasin M. Yes, an M is intended as a substantial improvement. Based on the lessons learned from the lengthy development, construction, and testing process for the original Yasin class. Kazan is reportedly quieter than the lead Yasin class boat. It's built with low magnetic steel to reduce its magnetic signature, which will make it much harder to detect. The Yasin class, unlike older Soviet vessels, are multi-mission boats similar to American Seawolf or Virginia classes. The Yasin M-class vessels are 120 meters long, have a submerged displacement of 13,800 tons, and can travel up to 31 knots, or 57 kilometers per hour, while submerged. They're also designed to dive to a maximum depth of 600 meters. Each ship of this class is designed to operate independently for up to 100 days. The submarine has massive armament capacity and is capable of anti-submarine, anti-ship, and land attack missions. Compared to the first vessel of class, Kazan will reportedly have 10 VLS silos, which are two more than Severodvinsk, and 8 torpedo tubes, which are two fewer when compared to Severodvinsk. The 10 VLS silos can carry 40, 10 times 4, Onyx missiles, or 50, 10 times 5, caliber missiles. P-800 Onyx is a supersonic cruise missile, capable of speed of up to Mach 2.5, and has a range of 600 kilometers or 373 miles. This will be used in the anti-ship role. The caliber is equivalent to the American Tomahawk cruise missile in many parameters, such as range, warhead, and propulsion. It has a 2,500 kilometer or 1,554 miles range, a 450 kilogram or 1,000 pound high explosive warhead, and a turbofan engine. Similar to Tomahawk, it has a speed of Mach 0.8. This will be used for land attacks. It's important to note that some variants of Onyx and Caliber can be armed with nuclear warheads. The same silos will be used to accommodate the Zircon. There are 8 torpedo tubes of 650 millimeters that carry 24, 8 times 3 heavyweight torpedoes. These can be equipped with Type 65 torpedo for anti-submarine warfare. The torpedo has a range of 100 kilometers or 62 miles. Kazan's elaborate armament makes it one of the most potent attack submarines. It will be a threat for the enemy's surface combatants, land targets, as well as submarines. The most important aspect of Zircon is its speed. The speed would give air defenses very little time to detect and fire interceptors. Current air defense systems can defend against subsonic missiles reliably and are effective against supersonic missiles to an extent, but against hypersonic missiles, they'll fail. It's to be noted that America's Government Accountability Office, GAO, report has stated that the US currently lacks the defenses required to protect against the latest crop of hypersonic weapons being developed by China and Russia. The report states, China and Russia are pursuing hypersonic weapons because their speed, altitude, and maneuverability may defeat most missile defense systems, and they may be used to improve long-range conventional and nuclear strike capabilities. There are no existing countermeasures. Viewers can go through the report from the link given in the description section below. In its response to the GAO, the Department of Defense described the report as an accurate, although sobering, macro picture of how the U.S. stands in the world against emerging threats. Another important aspect of the missile is its plasma cloud. As per multiple reports, the missile is completely covered by a plasma cloud during the flight. The plasma cloud would absorb radio frequencies emitted from radars, and since the waves are not reflected back, it will essentially mean that the missile will be invisible. It's highly likely that the missile will be detected very late, and this will make intercepting Zircon almost impossible with the current crop of air defense systems. Kazan armed with Zircon will be a credible threat to American assets, especially the U.S. Navy supercarrier and the carrier strike group. Since Zircon is heavy and fast, it will have lots of kinetic energy, which will come into play along with the explosive warhead, and a single hit from it could be enough to cripple even a supercarrier.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.